Hello my super babies, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be sharing with you this weight loss roti which has helped me a lot in the past. So why not share it with you? Okay, from my experience, gluten wali rotis made of wheat flour, maida is a weight gain for me and many others who I know. So for me, rice rotis are amazing. And it really helps me to maintain my weight, to lose my weight. It even helps me with glowing skin. It helps me with healthy hair. It's just not about weight loss. It even helps to maintain the weight, make you feel better. Because gluten, from my experience, is a terrible ingredient. From my experience, I've personally seen whenever I have rotis made of wheat flour, chapati ka aata, I see like a gradual weight gain. And my skin gets bad. My stomach is not so good. I have hair fall too. So in the long run, to have wheat rotis is not safe for me, and I know many others too. It's just not about myself. And rice rotis are amazing, so I want to share how we make it. Mom makes it amazingly and I want to share that with you. So if you have the greed to eat chapatis, make rice rotis. It is much better, at least from my experience. So if you're new to my channel, please subscribe. It'll mean a lot guys. Please don't forget to hit on that ghanta too, that bell, so that you get notified as soon as I upload a video. And yeah, go ahead and watch how to make it. So let's begin, babies. You need 1 cup of good quality rice flour, 3/4 cup of drinking water. Add it in the vessel and switch on the flame. Add in about a teaspoon of cooking oil. You can use whichever oil you like, or olive oil. Once the water starts boiling, switch off the flame and add in the rice flour. You need some strong tagada arms for this, because you need to use all your strength and mix it super well. Then close it with a lid and keep it aside, but try to work on it when it's warm. Your fingers, your palms should be able to take that heat. And then you start kneading it. It'll take a while. In between, you can add in some oil and knead and knead and knead. If you wanted to punch that special person's face but unable to do so, this is the time wherein you can sweetly punch that face. Assuming that it's that special person's face. I know it's a terrible joke, but I had to say this. So keep kneading till the dough is nice and soft, and then keep it in a dabba, airtight dabba. Keep it closed and then start getting ready to make the rotis. You can use any ring or a lid to make the circles for the rotis. Then you need some rice flour. So take a little bit of the dough and close the lid. Take a little bit of the oil and start kneading the dough again to bellify the rotis. Put in a little bit of the rice flour before you start making the rotis. You will need another plate too, and add in about a little bit of rice flour on that too. In between, do add a little bit of the rice flour. With the lid or with a ring, make a circle and keep it aside on that plate. And on top of that, put a little bit of rice flour again. Like that, make all the rotis with the remaining dough. And after keeping it on top of the other roti, please put a little bit of rice flour again for the next roti, and keep doing that for the next roti, so that none of the rotis get stuck to each other like chipko types. You must be having characters like these in your lives, right? So to avoid chipkos, apply rice flour. So with 1 cup of rice flour, we got 7 rotis. Now it's time to make the rotis. So we need all this, whatever I'm showing you, to make the rotis. So you need water too, and you need a burner. Now dust off all the excess rice flour as much as possible
And when you put the rotis on the pan for cooking, see to that where you had dusted the rice flour, that goes below, that goes down. That's the side which is touching the pan. After keeping it on the pan, sprinkle on some water. Meanwhile, get ready with the next roti, so you need to dust the excess rice flour. Once you flip this, the wet part is on the pan right now, so do not shake it, otherwise it'll get stuck. After a few seconds, do check if it is movable, and then move it and flip it and start cooking. It'll start fugofying, and then you can lastly put it on the burner and make it into a nice fulka. They're delicious, they're healthy, and it's amazing. I've had no stomach ache with these rotis, no skin issues. In fact, my skin glows, no hair fall issues. Overall, my health also feels excellent. So basically, these rotis are amazing. So I'll just do a little more demonstration with the other rotis and you can get a gist of it. So after you put the roti on the pan, sprinkle on some water. Then after a few seconds, flip it, then don't move it, and then cook it. Have it hot, because that's when it is super delicious. Have it with your curries. Ah, yummy. When you put it on the burner, see to that the wet side is on top, like you can see. Wet side bole to, wherein you sprinkle the water, that goes on top. How beautiful this looks, guys. Meanwhile, when you see the pan has a lot of rice flour on it, please dust it off carefully with a tissue paper.
So I hope you found this video useful, and if you want to see more videos on diet, on weight loss, please check my playlist. You will get everything out there, or comment or message me on my Instagram. I will definitely reply to you. And yeah, that's all. See you later in another video very soon. Bye bye.